Welcome back. My name is VITOR, this is my humanoid robot, and today we are doing some upgrades that will transform this pile of scraps into a project that is worth your screen time. The fact is, people want to see movement. They like to see the robot working, and that's why its hands are so important. In the last videos, I showed you how I built the Mark 1 and Mark 2 versions of the arm. But quite frankly, I didn't like it at all. And that's why we need a Mark 3. So let's take a look on what we already have and what we don't want in the next version. This is the left hand. You can see that the fingers all open and close together. And that's because it only has one servo. We need more. More servo motors means more movements. And I want at least four servos in the robot's hand so we can control the majority of the fingers separately. The main problem of this robot hand is the up and down movement velocity. It's too slow. But I was able to solve that issue with a set of gears and a more powerful stepper motor on Mark II. And this setup was actually very efficient and I plan to use it again. Other Mark II features are the forearm articulation and a claw instead of a hand.
Well, nothing bad for a $20 budget, right?
If you make a quick research about robotic hands, you will see that the majority of them use strings to move the fingers. And that implies a lot of problems, like the use of elastic material to return the fingers to the original position. And I tried to solve that in the Mark 1 by using a more rigid cable. That works, but I'm just not satisfied. I decided we don't need strings.
No strings on me.
To replace that, I thought of a set of 3D printed gears to move the fingers. But in order to save space, I had to change the concept to a form of a lever mechanism. Now let's cut his arm off. Starting by the robot's fingers.
I started by drawing concepts, making prototypes and testing until I could find a model that was worth 3D printing. As you know, I have a very limited printer. It can print only objects up to 4.5 inches in any dimension. Just this set of fingers is made of 22 parts, without counting the screws.
You know, I was thinking, how could I make these servo motors move the fingers? And I came up with a very MacGyver idea. And the reason I'm saying that is because we are using paper clips. I'll turn these paper clips into linkages that connect the servos to the finger levers, allowing the servos to pull and push them.
So much torque, the chassis twisted coming off the line.
I would be disappointed if we put this masterpiece into an old arm structure. So we are building a new one. Okay, now we are building the arm. And again, we start by the concepts and drawings. We want precision and strength, and that's why we're using servos again. But the bigger ones. We also want less weight possible. So it might be a good idea to use MDF boards for the arm structure. Yeah, I don't have a CNC laser cutter at home, so we're going to visit some friends and convince them to cut these parts for us. Cut this rectangle and make the servo fit inside the metal plate. It's not going to be... Remember that beautiful set of gears and bearings on Mark II? Yeah, I'm doing that again. I'm using the same kind of gearing. It's perfect for the job. The problem is the plastic around it. Well, it makes it very difficult to fit inside the PVC pipe, and that's why in the last version I tried to cut it, sand it, and it was a hell of a job. But with the experience I had with it, I realized that I could just throw it on the fire and wait until the plastic
was gone. By coincidence, the same type of bearing is also being used in the wrist rotation. The bearing center holds a metal threaded rod attached to a gear. If you're wondering what type of servo I'm using here, it's the MG996. It does its job and it's also very cheap. It's almost ready. The idea is that it will be a fully autonomous robot. But until then, we are building a controller to test and study the movements. I had one big servo motor left, so I decided to improve the next system and change these weird movements. I also found some parts to replace the old speaker chassis, use it as a neck, giving it a more clean look. After some days struggling to program the robot and the controller, I finally mastered the radio communication protocols. You know, this is a very cool project. I really enjoy building it and I pretend to keep working on it. The next thing I want to do is make it pour drinks. I think it would be very cool to see a robot serving drinks at a party. I think people would be very surprised. And other thing we need to do is a power supply. It is currently connected to a power outlet and I think it can be better than that. We can make a power supply for him, a battery pack, something similar to an arc reactor, like a battery pack that resembles an arc reactor, so we can put it right in the middle of his chest. It would be very cool also. So, of course, feel free to subscribe, watch other videos, see what I have built until now, and leave a thumbs up. You know, I do these videos because I like it, I won't stop doing it, but it's also very nice to see that other people like this kind of content. So, I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.